Joining us now to talk about Obama's approach and the world's harsh criticism of Israel, Clifford May, president of the Foundation for the Defense of Democracies, and Pat Buchanan, an MSNBC political analyst. Pat, we knocked this around the other night, Obama's silence. I want to start at a different point. A lot of people have criticized Israel for sort of its disproportionate response. And yet, after 9/11, the United States went into Afghanistan and killed a lot of people. Some would argue a lot more than were killed with 9/11. What's the difference?
Well, the difference is, in my judgment, Afghanistan, that was Al-Qaeda was responsible for bringing down those towers. If the Afghans had dealt with them, given us Osama bin Laden, we would not have gone in. We had a justification that was an act of war. The Israelis had been hit with for 6 months with these little rockets, which didn't kill anybody. It was outrageous, cruel, and stupid, and they triggered a blitzkrieg against the Palestinians in Gaza, which, in my judgment, is an Israeli concentration camp where 1.5 million people are locked up, cannot come out or go in. They've been controlling food, electricity, fuel, and the innocent people in Gaza are the ones suffering.
Here. Concentration camp, Pat, doesn't that diminish the significance of the real concentration camps?
No, I'm not talking about a death camp. I'm talking about what the British had in concentration camps in South Africa and what the Spanish had in Cuba and what others have had, where they bring all these people, lock them in there, and treat them with great cruelty and a humanitarian disaster, despite what Zippy Livni says.
Look, the people of Gaza could have peace tomorrow, and they could have an independent state the day after. All it would take is for Hamas to do two things. One, stop the missiles. You cannot have any country, even a country like Israel, simply accept that, okay, for the rest of our lives, and this has been going on for years now, we accept that they're going to be firing missiles at us. Some of them are small, some of them are bigger, they'll get bigger, but we accept this as a fact of life. We deserve to be hit with missiles. All Hamas would have to do is say, no more missiles starting tomorrow, we understand. And by the way, we accept Israel as a state, as a neighbor. We just want to negotiate the borders. Now, Hamas cannot do that because of its religious conviction that infidels may not anywhere in the Middle East be in power. Cannot do it. The best thing. All right, I don't want to go too long. But what I'm saying is, it's not a concentration camp. They could walk out of it tomorrow. They could walk to Egypt, by the way. Anybody they want to do, and they could have peace if they just stop the missile attacks. They haven't yet.
You know, that makes you wonder why the Israelis had a hand in creating Hamas to split Fatah.
Now, we're not going to get into what happened in Afghanistan.
Exactly. All right, let's go. All right, he says stop the missile firing and work for peace with Israel and you get your own state. Why don't they have a state on the West Bank then? They have done that, and the Israelis continue to steal their land. They build outposts
they want
and settlements.
All of Jerusalem, and that's why there's
Hold it. Let me talk here a second. And they have, of course, they have not agreed to have the Palestinians have their own capital in Jerusalem. The point is, why haven't they given back the Golan Heights? It's been peace on the Golan Heights since 1973.
As you know, in 2005, sure. Israel decided to leave Gaza and the occupation of Gaza. Every soldier, every settler came out. And the rationale was, look, if it's our occupation that's causing the violence, let's see what happens from our absence. They left, and there was a chance then that Hamas or the Palestinians then could have put hotels on the beaches, they could have had factories and schools, they could have taken over the greenhouses, and instead they made it into a terrorist enclave. Had Gaza become a functioning and free state, then the pressure inside Israel to give up everything or 97% of what's in the West Bank would have been enormous. There was no such pressure because Gaza became Hamas.
This is the Israeli Defense Ministry, excuse me, but when the 8,000 left Gaza, where did they go? They took them on the West Bank with American tax dollars, took Palestinian land, built new settlements, despite the fact that about 10 American presidents have said, please stop building settlements.
Hamas can't build schools. They have to throw missiles at Israel because Israel's not on the West Bank. Do you think
for a minute,
if Israel got off the West Bank, the missiles would stop? We know from Gaza it wouldn't.
But on the point of Obama, why can't Obama or somebody representing him articulate that very simple point?
Well, I think Obama is probably being smart to not say much right now. And the best present that Obama could have in the new administration is for Israel to defeat or at least cripple Hamas. Fatah would come back into Gaza and you'd have a new peace process, but a peace process that has a chance because there's no peace process you can have with Hamas if you understand Hamas. And I can't believe you don't understand Hamas's ideology.
Well, let me tell you how you create people for Hamas. You kill 675 people, you wound and injure 3,000. What do you think the brothers and sisters, those five little girls that died, what are they going to be when they grow up? What are these people
hopefully,
under this, treated like this?
You know.
Look, why do you think the Palestinians...
You know, and I know, that Hamas's doctrine, we can talk about it right here,
I know their
is
doctrine.
To hide in schools, in mosques, to hide among the civilians and use civilians for shields. And you know it is a war crime to use civilians for shields. You should be criticizing those war crimes on the part of Hamas.
Hamas, any war crimes, I criticize their attacks with those rockets, stupid and cruel. But you sit here and tell me that the Israeli people or the Israeli nation have treated the Palestinian people with any kind of justice. Those towns hit by the rockets are former Palestinian towns. Ashkelon, Ashdod,
speaking of justice, the issue we're getting into tomorrow is sort of the justice of the criticism of Israel, which to me seems like a complete double standard with the way we treat a lot of countries around the world. And that's a separate issue, and we'll get into that tomorrow. But Cliff May, Pat McKinnon, thank you both. We appreciate it.